chat, Brad. I'm being threatened with, to be arrested if I don't allow the officer to drop the blood.
And I'll be like the ambulance is trying to get me.
Hard, and I'm on the phone with his supervisor who's threatening me, threatened to arrest me. Can you call them for me just really quick and have them come out to the ambulance bay? I just came to get his business card. He got really upset. The officer on the other end of the phone, the lieutenant, is threatening me.
She handed the phone back to me. Okay.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yes, please. So I'm going to arrest her.
I'm in the emergency room.
Volunteer stage, please. Volunteer stage.
Start sending them. Start sending them. Thank you. Bye. Okay.
They're trying to draw.
My name is Alex. I'm one of the nurses.
The officer is right here, and I'm trying to turn this in the evening. We don't know where the officer is.
We have exigent circumstances for a blood draw on a patient that's upstairs. She is refusing, and my lieutenant says that if she doesn't...
What department are you with?
Salt Lake City Police.
Salt Lake City.
Which I'm sure you'll get to meet my lieutenant soon. And if I don't get to go get the blood, I'm taking her to jail.
Okay.
I'd rather not do that.
I'd rather you not do it either. Let's draw it to be safe for...
I have been told by risk management in the health security office, the health supervisor, that we're not allowed to let him draw blood unless he has a warrant to do so.
Okay.
And he doesn't.
Okay. Cool. All right, so let's do it. I'll call the officer. I'll call the officer.
Thank you. officer here. I'm trying to prohibit him from driving blood on one of my patients who he does not have a warrant for.
Hello. If things still keep going the way they're going, I'm arresting her. For interfering with a criminal investigation.
To draw blood on a patient.
Okay.
I've been told by risk management, the health privacy officer, the health supervisor, and my manager all agree.
Here's the thing. If he's conducting an investigation, it's obstructing justice.
Okay, I'm just being told what to do by my entire hospital.
And I'm being told what to do by my boss.
Okay, so.
And I'm gonna do what my boss says.
Okay, well, and I can stand here and say I wanna do the same thing. There's no urgency in this. I'd rather just let it work out. I'd rather just try and figure out.
It was fatal, and he's the other driver. He's in, I guess, critical condition in the burn unit. And so the implied consent law says that we can draw blood, and she's preventing it.
I'm preventing because that's what I'm told to do by the risk management for the hospital, the hospital officer, privacy HIPAA officer, the health supervisor, and my boss.
I told how could you should be doing.
Okay.
Thank you very much, Alex.
We'll just hang tight.
There's nothing urgent. Like, I just, we need to just call, like,
yeah.
There's no reason that this has gotten as elevated as it has. Okay, so the police from the university had to show up and seem to agree with this officer. But also,
if you want to arrest him, I'm not going to stop him.
He said if this guy's going to arrest me, he's not going to stop him.
For a second, we're not doing one thing or another until House Soup gets here, yeah?
Yeah, and I've got more of my guys coming up, so. Nope, that's my job, and anybody who interferes with the arrest, and we don't want to do that either.
Just a minute. You want to wait for House Soup to get here?
You what? Mm-hmm. Yeah, they flew the one guy here.
Where at?
It's up in Logan.
Oh. These two officers are threatening to arrest me if I,
no, I am.
Let them. This officer's threatening to arrest me. He's agreeing with this officer. I've talked to, I have the cell phone number. Brad's on the phone, so he's calling Colleen. I've called risk management. They talked to the security privacy officer, and he said adamantly that if the patient is not under arrest and he needs to have a warrant signed by a judge that says he can draw blood, and he doesn't have.
And there's also the laws that talk about exigent circumstances and implied consent law, which does apply.
Okay, I can have you talk to our privacy officer.
Okay, well.
But until he says yes, he can't.
Okay, she's going to jail.
Why?
Interfering with the criminal investigation. Okay. Per my watch commander, and I'm not going to argue with him.
Okay, this is coming from our leadership.
Okay,
as well.
And it's coming from mine. So we've got two leaderships that can butt heads together later, but I either go away with blood and vials or body and toe. And that's my only choices. I'm going to follow my boss's instructions. That is my instructions.
Can I talk to Brad?
Absolutely.
I would like someone to stay with me. I do not feel
okay with Alex.
I'm totally fine as long as Alex is okay.
We're good.
This is not the way I wanted this
to
be.
No, it's not the way anybody wants anything to do.
No.
We're just all trying to follow our own letters of law. Like you said, we've got bosses and stuff that are butting heads.
Yep.
We're just trying to do the best what's for everybody, right?
Mm-hmm. Hi, this is Hotel 6-3 up at the University of Utah. I guess you've got cars coming my way. Okay, tell them I'm in the ER. Any idea of an ETA?
I didn't want to get involved in this.
Okay. He's right here. He's going to be right here. We're outside, but I can't hear
him. He's not here to protect me. He's here to...
No one's going to hurt no one in here. Okay.
I just do not feel safe right now.
I am the third part. I can't. So it's his investigation. I can't do anything.
Okay. Let them know we're in the ER. We were upstairs. We're not now. Okay? Thank you. Right. Hello.
What's up, Payne?
This young lady right here, right now, is not free to go about her business. Per watch command, if she does not allow me to go get a blood draw from a guy up in the burn unit, she's going to jail.
Okay.
Per watch command. They don't want to abide by the implied consent law or exigent circumstances. They want it to be a search warrant. And it's on a fatal crash. The guy's unconscious.
So where's the lieutenant? He's coming in.
I've talked to him on the phone. She's talked to him on the phone. He was the first one to tell her that if I don't get the blood, she's getting arrested. And then he can talk to her face to face when he does the arrest check. I'm just stating what will happen.
We can both say that, sir. I'm just a nurse trying to protect the patients and do what my hospital has obligated me to do.
Believe it or not, I'm trying to protect him, too. I'm not trying to get him on criminal charges.
I didn't say you were. I'm just trying to do innocently what I've been told to do.
Okay. And so
am
I. They don't have PC. I talked to Logan. It's their case. We've already discussed that with them. And watch command talked to her and says, no, this is the deal. And she says, nope, this is the deal. He told her if she interferes in any way in me getting the blood draw, she is to be arrested.
So it can't be the first time this is. So why is it weird now? You know?
I've had run into something similar, but they ended up consenting. I've never gone this far.
Where's her boss?
Oh, she's been talking to him on the phone. Were you the only one come up, or are there more?
As far as I know, I'm the only one.
So am I. By the way, can I get a consent to release form for somebody to send in to get medical records?
Have that.
Who would I?
You get to call medical records.
Okay.
There should be a phone number to call. I can get your phone number.
If you could, I'd appreciate it, because it'd make at least one part of my night better. That's where we're going. And right now, that's where it's going.
Yes, do it. Or 2353.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
They might not be open right now, but...
No, I don't expect them to be.
Just call them, do whatever you need.
I'll call them tomorrow. They all have to figure out what the code is, probably.
Hold on, Brad. So, I printed this off. This is what I was told to print off. And, hold on. Brad, I'm just putting on speaker so you can... So, I have this... It says obtaining blood samples for police enforcement from patients suspected to be under the influence. Okay? This is something that you guys agree to with this hospital. The three things that allow us to do that are if you have an electronic warrant, patient consent, or patient under arrest. And neither of those things, the patient can't consent. He told me repeatedly that he doesn't have a warrant and the patient is not under arrest. So I'm just trying to do what I'm supposed to do. That's all. So.
Okay, so I take it without those in place, I'm not going to get blood. Is that... Am I fair to surmise that?
Alex, you're not representing... You're not representing...
Yeah, I'm...
Okay.
I don't know. I have no idea why he's blaming me. I'm just representing...
Why are you blaming the messenger, sir?
She's the one that has told me no.
Yeah, but sir, you're making a huge mistake right now.
Okay. Okay. No, we're done. We're done. You're under arrest. We're going. We're done.
Stop it!
We're
done.
Stop it! Stop it! We're done.
On the way.
Run!
Sir, hey, whoa. I have it in the hospital.
okay. She can sit in my car while we're there coming.
This is unnecessary, man.
You're right.
This is my department. And this is completely unnecessary.
Completely,
completely
unnecessary.
Unnecessary.
She's under arrest.
That's fine, but it doesn't have
for
to be
doing
like
her
this.
Job.
Okay, I'm doing what my job. She does hers.
That's fine.
Okay, I'm leaving now with her.
So
okay, anybody who wants to prevent that, that's your option. He will be taking them. Okay? So, take your hand off her, please.
I have hospital administration coming. Can he talk to you?
Just please.
Sure.
Why are you so... Please, sir, you're hurting me.
Then walk.
No, I have no reason to walk. Stop. You're hurting me and assaulting me. Please, I can't believe it.
Have a seat.
Brad, what is going on?
Detective Payne, University of Utah, about ready to leave. Headed for watch command. You're out in front of the hospital? Oh, good. We're at the ER. I'll come around to you. You can... Yeah, I've got her in my car right now. We're at my car. No, black car. I'm looking for my car. H63. Okay. Thank you. Hi, sir.
Hi.
Would you like to speak to this young lady?
Well, I need to talk to you first, and then I'll talk to her.
Hey.
Hi, this is Brad, supervisor again. Hey, they have arrested the burn person.
Do you want me on camera off?
Right here. Can I sit down to be able to have you tell him?
So
they're arresting her for obstruction.
She's called people. They say, no, she will not take me up there. And they're refusing.
Chief of police here too. Can I put you on speakerphone to talk to them?
So she absolutely will not.
Thank you. I have our privacy officer on the call.
They're busy. Give me a second.
So
need just a second.
Well, I mean, yeah, it's okay. Let me chat with her for a minute.
Hey, can you give me a second? He will talk to you. I can promise you that. Give me a second.
So I guess I wasn't clear on the phone.
Here's the problem.
Okay. No. See, you're still talking. You were doing it on the phone too, okay? The problem is this. Okay? You're telling me what your policy is, and I appreciate that you have a problem.
It's not my policy.
No. I know.
I
understand that. You're telling me what a policy is. A workplace policy. What people, it's what lawyers and stuff put together to prevent liability from coming on the hospital.
Now, had you taken the officer up, we could have had
it's not an issue of me taking it up. I'm also obligated to my patient and to protect them.
Okay, the person that you're trying to protect is the victim in a fatal crash. Okay,
I'm being told what to do and what my...
Okay. Okay.
I've been told.
And what I'm trying to tell you is, we wanted blood from this guy. Now, I have talked to people, and there's probably a much better solution that we could have come to, okay? But all we had to do was go up and get the blood, okay? And my point is, there are civil. If we're breaking the law, if we're doing wrong,
call
okay?
Tom Miller or somebody.
Listen to me. If we're doing wrong, there are civil remedies, okay? It's called fruits of the poisonous tree. If we took this blood illegally, it all goes away, all right? So there's civil remedies if we make a mistake. What I'm telling you is, we are not making a mistake, okay? I've done this for 22 plus years. I know what the law is when it comes to search and seizure, all right? And what you have done, because your bosses are telling you to, has been to prevent this officer who was called out to do a job to do his job. That's obstructing justice. Okay? I understand you're not trying, but you're succeeding. That's the problem. Okay? And so what we want to do is tell me this. Is it practice for the hospital to draw? Did he come in unconscious? So you can't even answer my question.
No, I'm happy to. I don't know. I presume he came on unconscious.
Okay. But see, do you take blood from him?
Yeah.
As soon as they come in, right?
Because he's a patient.
Okay.
We have to protect our patients.
I understand that. Okay. If I knew that beforehand, I would have just had told Logan to come and get a warrant and access that blood that you guys have already drawn. Okay. But this is stuff that we can discuss, not when you're telling me, no, I'm not going to do it.
Said,
when I tried to explain my point, you said it doesn't matter what you say. I'm not letting you go up.
No, I did not say that. I specifically said I've been told that you have to have a warrant signed by a judge.
Right. And I'm telling you,
he has to be under arrest.
No.
And I just wanted to clarify it with both my house supervisor here and the people that were telling me that information.
Do you know, is this person a resident? Do you know we're trying to get blood from?
I have no idea. I don't even know who
he is.
Another
problem. So why are you involved in this?
Because
you don't have anything to do with it.
Because I'm the charge nurse in the unit that he was admitted.
Okay, so
and my job is to help understand what we're supposed to do and how.
You're not trying to understand. You're trying to tell us no. That's all you're doing. Because I'm trying to explain something. And all I'm hearing is, well, I can't. No. And I'm trying to tell you, I understand that is the policy position. But your policy doesn't affect my legal standing to do
there are, yes, there are people coming, and I have Tracy coming for it. So hang tight.
Conversation with before I'm told no. Okay? There's a very bad habit up here of your policy interfering with my law. Okay? I am trying to conduct a criminal investigation, step through the process, okay? And you guys are trying to prevent liability coming on the hospital. And I appreciate that, but those sometimes don't meet and they don't match up. And so I gotta decide what we're gonna do with this young lady, because I need to find out if this guy has a Utah driver's license. If he does,
then we know his name.
I have his name.
Gray, yeah. William Gray, about how old is
William
Gray?
Here.